खुदा हाफिज इज ए 2020 इंडियन हिंदी लैंग्वेज एक्टर थ्रिलर फिल्म रिटन एंड डायरेक्टेड बाय फारूक कबीर एंड प्रोड्यूस्ड बाय कुमार मंगत पाठक एंड अभिषेक पाठक अंडर पैनोरमा स्टूडियोज। इट स्टार्स विद जामवाल एंड शिवा लेखा ओबराय विद अनु कपूर आहाना कुमरा एंड शिव पंडित इन सपोर्टिंग रोल सेट ड्यूरिंग द फाइनेंशियल क्राइसिस ऑफ 2007-2008। The film is inspired by the true events and follows Sameer Chaudhary, a young man who races against time to rescue his kidnapped wife Nargis from flash traders. The film was premiered on Disney Plus Hotstar on 14 August 2020 and it received largely positive reviews from audience. And the movie came out in the lockdown of 2020. Because of the pandemic, the movie couldn't release on the theater of India globally or detained by cops in a fictional Middle East country named Noman Sameer Chaudhary, which is known as in the movie Castro, Vidya Chawal agrees to reveal what led to his arrest to Mishra and Indian embassy official. In a flashback, we see that Sameer is a software engineer and businessman who falls in love with Nargis and marries her in 2007. A financial crisis in 2008 leaves them both jobless. 3 months later, they get a job in Noman with the help of Nandini, an employee at an overseas recruitment company. Nargis leaves first and Sameer stays to wait for his documents to come. After her arrival, Nargis calls Sameer in a panic, crying that someone is kidnapping her. Sameer travels to Noman, where he meets Usman Hamid Ali Murad, a taxi driver. He asks Usman to take him to the addresses given by Nadeem, but learns there is no such address. Usman takes Sameer to the police station, where he learns that Nadeem has gone missing. With cops not helping him, he approaches the Indian embassy he possesses as an employee of a telecom company and acquires the address of the person from whose phone Nargis contacted him, a man named Shirazi. Sameer and Usman learn about Shirazi's involvement in the flash trade. Sameer visits brothels and with Usman in search of Nargis and finds her in one, but he is attacked by the owners and turns out violent, killing man, followed by a car chase that ends with a crash and his arrest. In the prison, as Sameer has finished narrating his story, he is approached by a Nomani cop named Faiz who decided to help him with Officer Tamina. They view the CCTV footage of the Noman airport, where they see Nargis entering a van with a man revealed to by Stack, an Algerian modeling coordinator. Stack orders the killing of Nargis. Faiz and Tamina come across a burned corpse and believe it to be Nargis. Sameer sees her pendant and on it and is shattered. Following her funeral, he is given compensation tickets to India. Tamina learns Nargis is alive and the corpse they found was of different woman. She and Faiz try to find Sameer before landing. He never boarded the flight. Now wanting revenge, Sameer disguises himself and arrives at his tech house. The two violently fight before Stack reveals Nargis is alive. Faiz and Tamina arrive and Faiz is revealed to be Stackly alive. Tamina subdues Faiz long enough to allow Sameer to escape. Faiz kills Tamina and frames Sameer. An ensuing chase leaves Stack dead. Faiz meets his crime partner, the boss of Stack, which is photographed by an undercover cop. Sameer is captured by Faiz before his betrayal is revealed by the commissioner. Sameer and Faiz engage in first fight where Sameer beats Faiz. Nargis and The other women are freed and Tamina is given a state funeral. Fez wakes up in found in the middle of a desert in front of a firing squad for his crime. They shot him to death. Samin and Nargis prepare to depart the plain of India while making the last meeting with Usman. Samin invites Usman to come to India and meet with their family. Before leaving, they call him Khuda Hafiz. This movie is following official announcement in April 2019. Shooting commenced at Uzbekistan on 14 November 2019 before the pandemic, the halting COVID started. And this movie is officially conducted at virtual press conference where Disney Plus Hotstar hosted played the movie India. A sequel titled Khuda Hafiz Chapter 2 was announced in September 22 with Kumar Mangat and Abhishek Pathak as the producer and Farooq Kabir as the director. Vidhu Chambal and Shivalekha Oberoi will reprise their roles and the sequels will go on close in March 21 before releasing in October 2019 in cinema. What other people say about this movie, Khuda Hafiz? Shridhar Kumar Menon wrote, "Back to my favorite movie writing. This time it will be a memorable one, as the movie I had seen over an OTT platform. Till now, experience of movie was in a multiplex screen, relaxing on a couch over the top row and enjoying the show with a big box of popcorn. Thanks to COVID, which was giving me a different view of experiencing the movie." Khuda Hafiz is a perfect weekend watch movie. Vidhu Chambal, who had been seen a full of an action hero in Commando series, performing breathtaking stunts, where he had shown that this caliber is not only restricted to only action generation movies. A day back of release, director Farooq Kabir had said that he had confidence on taking out Vidhu into his role, and today I applaud his forecast. Yes, Vidhu had done a marvelous act. The story revolves around the 2008 depression, where today at this COVID situation, the people who are affected the most is the middle class and the lower middle class. Here Samir lies with Vidhu and his wife Nargis lies Shivalekha Oberoi, facing financial crisis due to 2008 crisis and throw a job opportunity in Oman. Nargis fires so that a ray of sunshine enters into their life, but ill fate makes Nargis fall into the trap and become a victim of the anti-social group. And now, how Samir, who lands in Oman, rescues her forms the rest of the story. The story will very well show the difficulty of the common man whose only aim is to be their family happy and safe. We hear a lot of where women work in abroad as nurses, clerks, etc. Why? Just to show that they are working abroad in vacation, they will bring costly products and impress the society. No, in most cases they just toiled day, night, and to spend a good amount back to their family at hometown so as to meet their daily and win. When this kind of situation happens, it's nothing but ill fit. When it comes to performance, I mentioned Vidhu had shown a different style. The pain, the worry of a husband who just wants to get his wife back at any situation is very well enacted. Bollywood will definitely make with a superstar soon. Shivalekha Oberoi had done her part very well. Anu Kapoor, man who shone a remarkable performance in Jolly LLB, too, here was not left any chance of complaint. Kudos for them. Director Farooq Kabir had well researched on this as the true event, very well executed. As the viewers, filmmakers like should bring such fantabulous scripts which will make us the viewers watch with great level of interest. Yet one thing the movie teaches is we believe in God, then there is no obstacle which will make us fail. Khuda Hafiz, who gave this movie 5 out of 5. And here's one of the reviewer, name is Navaparna Gautam. She wrote, amazing movie based on some of the true and present happenings going on around the world, around very every corner of the cities. Besides that, it shows that true love of respect for that on one and only soul partners. And yes, we should learn from them. Despite being abused physically, she is solely made for him, and that is not about fate. It's all about confidence, love, and humanity. Let's support, save, and strengthen humanity rather than trading humans. People need people, and we have one life to live. Let's be together with our loved ones, and let's stay together happy. A peace, beautiful picture shot in Uzbekistan, which is indeed a beautiful, wonderful place, prompts to be appreciated for the cinematography, delineates and magnificence. Director Khuda Hafiz, which means goodbye. A notable performance by Faiz Abu Malik featuring Shiv Pandit and Arab security agent officer deserves credit, plus his appearance in his movie film benefits a stunning commando for his thrilling action as an antagonist. Stunning performance by protagonists, although I'll have to say superb performance by all characters. And this film has strongly focused on human integrity and suppressing corruption with its own boundary. I appreciate such encouraging production. Another reviewer, Shorab Chaudhary. First, thank to Farooq Kabir for his wonderful direction. Finally, Sameer gets Nargis after long hurdle, and it is shining example of authentic love. After long time watched fresh content, most of the time I used to watch Vidhu Chamal action-packed movie, but this time I saw emotional romantic thriller, which is a perfect combination of versatility. Twist is there as well, suspense, location, storyline, concept, background, music was good. Sameer and Nargis had bitter and painful journey from Lucknow to Noman as Nargis got trapped by woman trafficking. This movie beautifully illustrated how women fall in trap of trafficking. Vidhu Chamal as Sameer Chaudhary, Nargis' husband, was outstanding right from the beginning of the movie. He did not run off the way to search Nargis, as it was little. Shivalekha Oberoi as Nargis Chaudhary, Sameer's wife, was good. Anu Kapoor as Usman Hamid Ali Murad, taxi driver in Oman who gives a constant support to Sami despite his life risk, other cast as well. Overall, this movie is very much watchable and friends and family. So this was my review of the Khuda Hafiz and other people says about this movie. I have told in the briefly, so you can watch it guys. This movie is really really good, and you can watch it on Hotstar completely. So thank you for watching guys. Khuda Hafiz is a 2020 Indian Hindi language action thriller film written and directed by Farooq Kabir and produced by Kumar Mangat Pathak and Abhishek Pathak under Panorama Studios. It stars Vidhu Chamal and Shivalekha Oberoi with Anu Kapoor, Ahana Kumra and Shiv Pandit in supporting roles. Set during the financial crisis of 2007-2008. The film is inspired by the true events and follows Sameer Chaudhary, a young man who races against time to rescue his kidnapped wife Nargis from flash traders. The film was premiered on Disney Plus Hotstar on 14 August 2020 and it received largely positive reviews from audience. And the movie came out in the lockdown of 2020. Because of the pandemic, the movie couldn't release on the theater of India globally. Or detained by cops in a fictional Middle East country named Noman Samir Chaudhary, which is known as in the movie Castrol, Vidya Jamwal agrees to reveal what the led to his arrest to Mishra, an Indian embassy official. In a flashback, we see that Samir is a software engineer and businessman who falls in love with Nargis and marries her in 2007. A financial crisis in 2008 leaves them both jobless. 3 months later, they get a job in Noman with the help of Nadeem, an employee at an overseas recruitment company. Nargis leaves first and Samir stays to wait for his documents to come. After her arrival, Nargis calls Samir in a panic, crying that someone is kidnapping her. Samir travels to Noman where he meets Usman Hamid Ali Murad, a taxi driver. He asks Usman to take him to the addresses given by Nadeem, but learns there is no such address. Usman takes Samir to the police station where he learns that Nadeem has gone missing. With cops not helping him, he approaches the Indian embassy he possesses as an employee of a telecom company and acquires the address of the person from whose phone Nargis contacted him, a man named Shirazi. Samir and Usman learn about Shirazi's involvement in the flash trade. Samir visits brothels and with Usman in search of Nargis and finds her in one, but he is attacked by the owners and turns on violent, killing man, followed by a car chase that ends with a crash and his arrest. In the present, as Samir has finished narrating his story, he is approached by a Nomani cop named Faiz who decided to help him with Officer Tamina. They view the CCTV footage of the Noman airport where they see Nargis entering a van with a man revealed to by Stack, an Algerian modeling coordinator. Stack orders the killing of Nargis. Faiz and Tamina come across a burned corpse and believe it to be Nargis. Samir sees her pendant and on it and is shattered. Following her funeral, he is given compensation tickets to India. Tamina learns Nargis is alive and the corpse they found was of different woman. She and Faiz try to find Samir before learning he never boarded the flight. Now wanting revenge, Samir disguises himself and arrives at Stack house. The two violently fight before Stack reveals Nargis is alive. Faiz and Tamina arrive and Faiz is revealed to be Stackly alive. Tamina subdues Faiz long enough to allow Samir to escape. Faiz kills Tamina and frames Samir. An ensuing chase leaves Stack dead. Faiz meets his crime partner, the boss of Stack, which is photographed by an undercover cop. Samir is captured by Faiz before his betrayal is revealed by the commissioner. Samir and Faiz engage in first fight where Samir beats Faiz. Nargis and the other woman are freed and Tamina is given a state funeral. Faiz wakes up found in the middle of a desert in front of a firing squad for his crime. They shot him to death. Samir and Nargis prepare to depart the plane of India while making the last meeting with Usman. Samir invites Usman to come to India and meet with their family. Before leaving, they call him Khuda Hafiz. This movie is following official announcement in April 2019, Schrodinger commenced at Uzbekistan on 14 November 2019 before the pandemic, the all-time COVID started. And this movie is officially conducted at virtual press conference where Disney Plus Hotstar hosted played the movie India. A sequel titled Khwaja Hafiz Chapter 2 was announced in September 22 with Kumar Mangat and Abhishek Pathak as a producer and Farooq Kabir as the director. Vidhu Chawal and Shivalekha Oberoi will reprise their roles and the sequels will go on floors in March 21 before releasing in October 2019 in cinema. What other people says about this movie, Khuda Hafiz. Shridhar Kumar Menon wrote, "Back to my favorite movie writing. This time it will be a memorable one as the movie I had seen over an OTT platform. Till now experience of movie was in a multiplex screen, relaxing on a couch over the top row and enjoying the show with a big box of popcorn. Thanks to COVID, which was gave me a different view of experiencing the movie." He wrote, Khuda Hafiz, a perfect weekend watch movie to Jamal, who had been seen a full of an action hero in Commando series performing breathtaking stunts, where he had shown that this caliber is not only restricted to only action generation movies. A day back of release, director Farooq Kabir had said that he had confidence on taking out Vidhu into his role, and today I applaud his forecast. Yes, Vidhu had done a marvelous act. The story revolves around the 2008 depression, where today at this COVID situation, the people who are affected the most is the middle class and the lower middle class. Here Samir lies with Vidhu and his wife Nargis lies Shivalekha Oberoi facing financial crisis due to 2008 crisis and throw a job opportunity in Oman. Nargis fires so that a ray of sunshine enters into their life, but ill fate makes Nargis falls into the trap and become a victim of the anti-social group. And now how Samir, who lands in Oman, rescue her forms the rest of the story. The story will very well show the difficulty of the common man whose only aim is to be their family happy and safe. We hear a lot of where women work in abroad as nurses, clerks, etc. Why just to show that they are working abroad in vacation, they will bring costly products and impress the society? No. In most cases, they just toiled day, night, and to spend a good amount back to their family at hometown so as to meet their daily and win. When this kind of situation happens, it's nothing but ill fit. When it comes to performance, I mentioned Vidhu had shown a different style. The pain, the worry of husband who just wants to get his wife back at any situation is very well enacted. Bollywood will definitely make Vidhu a superstar soon. Shivalekha Oberoi had done her part very well. Anu Kapoor, man who shown a remarkable performance in Jolly LLB 2 here, was not left any chance of complaint. Kudos for them. Director Farooq Kabir had well researched on this as the true event, very well executed. As the viewers, filmmakers like should bring such fantabulous scripts which will make us the viewers watch will create level of interest. Yes, one thing the movie rich teaser is we believe in God, then there is no obstacle which will make us fail. Khuda Hafiz, who gave this movie 5 out of 5. And here's one of the reviewer name is Navaparna Gautam. She wrote, amazing movie based on some of the true and pleasant happenings going on around the world, around every corner of the cities. Besides that, it shows that true love of respect for that on one and only soul partners. And yes, we should learn from them. Despite being abused physically, she is solely made for him, and that is not about fate. It's all about confidence, love, and humanity. Let's support, save, and strengthen humanity rather than trading humans. Pupils need pupils, and we have one life to live. Let's be together with our loved ones, and let's stay together happy. A piece, beautiful picture shot in Uzbekistan, which is indeed a beautiful, wonderful place, prompts to be appreciated for the cinematography, delineates and magnificence. Title Khuda Hafiz, which means goodbye, a notable performance by Faiz Abu Malik featuring Shiv Pandit and Arab security agent officer deserves credit, plus his appearance in his movie film benefits a stunning commando for his thrilling action as an antagonist. Stunning performance by protagonists, although I'll have to say superb performance by all characters. And this film has strongly focused on human integrity and suppressing corruption with its own boundary. I appreciate such encouraging production. Another reviewer, Shorab Chaudhary. First, thank to Farooq Kabir for his wonderful direction. Finally, Sameer gets Nargis after long hurdle, and it is shining example of authentic love. After long time watched fresh content, most of the time I used to watch Vidhu Chamal action-packed movie, but this time I saw emotional romantic thriller, which is a perfect combination of versatility, twist is there as well, suspense, location, storyline, concept, background, music was good. Sameer and Nargis had bitter and painful journey from Lucknow to Noman as Nargis got trapped by woman trafficking. This movie beautifully illustrated how women fall in trap of trafficking. Vidhu Jamwal as Sameer Chaudhary, Nargis' husband, was outstanding right from the beginning of the movie. He did not run off the way to search Nargis, as it was lethal. Shivalekha Oberoi as Nargis Chaudhary, Sameer's wife, was good. Annu Kapoor as Usman Hamid Ali Murad, taxi driver in Noman, who gives a constant support to Sameer despite his life risk, other cast as well. Overall, this movie is very much watchable, and friends and family. So this was my review of the Khuda Hafiz, and other people says about this movie have told in the briefly, so you can watch it guys. This movie is really really good, and you can watch it on Hotstar completely. So thank you for watching guys. Khuda Hafiz is a 2020 Indian Hindi language action thriller film written and directed by Farooq Kabir and produced by Kumar Mangat Pathak and Abhishek Pathak under Panorama Studios. It stars Vidhu Jamwal and Shivalekha Oberoi with Annu Kapoor, Ahana Kumara and Shiv Pandit in supporting roles. Set during the financial crisis of 2007-2008, the film is inspired by the true events and follows Sameer Chaudhary, a young man who races against time to rescue his kidnapped wife Nargis from flash traders. The film was premiered on Disney Plus Hotstar on 14 August 2020 and it received largely positive reviews from audience. And the movie came out in the lockdown of 2020. Because of the pandemic, the movie couldn't release on the theater of India globally. Or detained by cops in a fictional Middle East country named Noman, Sameer Chaudhary, which is known as in the movie Castrol, Vidhu Chamwal, agrees to reveal what the lad to his arrest to Mishra, an Indian embassy official. In a flashback, we see that Samir is a software engineer and businessman who falls in love with Nargis and marries her in 2007. A financial crisis in 2008 leaves them both jobless. 3 months later, they get a job in Noman with the help of Nandini, an employee at an overseas recruitment company. Nargis leaves first and Samir stays to wait for his documents to come. After her arrival, Nargis calls Samir in a panic, crying that someone is kidnapping her. Samir travels to Noman where he meets Usman Hamid Ali Murad, a taxi driver. He asks Usman to take him to the addresses given by Nadim, but learns there is no such address. Usman takes Samir to the police station where he learns that Nadim has gone missing. With cops not helping him, he approaches the Indian embassy he possesses as an employee of a telecom company and acquires the address of the person from whose phone Nargis contacted him, a man named Shirazi. Samir and Usman learn about Shirazi's involvement in the flash trade. Samir visits brothels and with Usman in search of Nargis and finds her in one, but he is attacked by the owners and turns out violent, killing man, followed by a car chase that ends with a crash and his arrest. In the prison, as Samir has finished narrating his story, he is approached by a Nomani cop named Faiz, who decided to help him with Officer Tamina. They view the CCTV footage of the Noman airport, where they see Nargis entering a van with a man jeweled to buy a stack, an Algerian modeling coordinator. Stack orders the killing of Nargis. Faiz and Tamina come across a burned corpse and believe it to be Nargis. Samir sees her pendant and on it and is shattered. Following her funeral, he is given compensation tickets to India. Tamina learns Nargis is alive and the corpse they found was of different woman. She and Faiz try to find Samir before learning he never boarded the flight. Now wanting revenge, Samir disguises himself and arrives at Stack House. The two violently fight before Stack reveals Nargis is alive. Faiz and Tamina arrive and Faiz is revealed to be Stackly alive. Tamina subdues Faiz long enough to allow Samir to escape. Faiz kills Tamina and frames Samir. An ensuing chase leaves Stack dead. Faiz meets his crime partner, the boss of Stack, which is photographed by an undercover cop. Samir is captured by Faiz before his betrayal is revealed by the commissioner. Samir and Faiz engage in first fight where Samir beats Faiz. Nargis and the other women are freed and Tamina is given a state funeral. Faiz wakes up found in the middle of a desert in front of a firing squad for his crime. They shot him to death. Samir and Nargis prepare to depart the plane of India while making the last meeting with Usman. Samir invites Usman to come to India and meet with their family. Before leaving, they call him to the office. This movie is following official announcement in April 2019. Shooting commenced at Uzbekistan on 14 November 2019 before the pandemic, the halting COVID started. And this movie is officially conducted at a virtual press conference where Disney Plus Hotstar played the movie India. A sequel titled Khwaya Hafiz Chapter 2 was announced in September 22 with Kumar Mangat and Abhishek Pathak as a producer and Farooq Kabir as the director विद्युत चावल एंड शिवालेखा ओब्राई विल रिप्राइज देयर रोल्स एंड द सीक्वेंस विल कम ऑन प्लस इन मार्च 21 बिफोर रिलीजिंग इन अक्टूबर 2019 इन सिनेमा. What other people says about this movie, Khudafi. Sujit Kumar Menon wrote, Back to my favorite movie writing. This time it will be a memorable one as the movie I had seen over an OTT platform. Till now experience of movie was in a multiplex screen, relaxing on a couch over the top row and enjoying the show with a big box of popcorn. Thanks to COVID, which was gave me a different view of experiencing the movie. He wrote, Khudafiz, a perfect weekend watch movie to Jamal, who had been seen a full of an action hero in Commando series, performing breathtaking stunts, where he had shown that this caliber is not only restricted to only action generation movies. A day back of release, director Farooq Kabir had said that he had confidence on taking out Vidyut into his role, and today I applaud his forecast. Yes, Vidyut had done a marvelous act. The story revolves around the 2008 depression, where today at this COVID situation, the people who are affected the most is the middle class and the lower middle class. Here Samir lies with Vidyut and his wife Nargis lies Shivalekha Oberoi, facing financial crisis due to 2008 crisis and throw a job opportunity in no man. Nargis fires so that a ray of sunshine enters into their life, but ill fate makes Nargis fall into the trap and become a victim of the anti-social group. And now how Samir, who lands in no man, rescue her forms the rest of the story. The story will very well show the difficulty of the common man whose only aim is to be their family happy and safe. We hear a lot of where women work in abroad as nurses, clerks, etc. Why just to show that they are working abroad in vacation, they will bring costly products and impress the society. No. In most cases, they just toiled day, night, and to spend a good amount back to their family at hometown so as to meet their daily and win. When this kind of situation happens, it's nothing but ill fate. When it's come to performance, I mentioned Vidyut had shown a different style. The pain, the worry of husband who just wants to get his wife back at any situation is very well enacted. Bollywood will definitely make Vidyut a superstar soon. Shivalekha Oberoi had done her part very well. Anu Kapoor, man who shown a remarkable performance in Jolly LLB 2, here was not left any chance of complaint. Kudos for them. Director Farooq Kabir had well researched on this as the true event, very well executed. As the viewers, filmmakers like should bring such fantabulous scripts which will make us the viewers watch will great level of interest. Yes, one thing the movie teaser is we believe in God, then there is no obstacle which will make us fail. Khudafiz, who gave this movie 5 out of 5. And here's one of the reviewer, name is Navaparna Gautam. She wrote, amazing movie based on some of the true and pleasant happenings going on around the world, around very every corner of the cities. Besides that, it shows that true love of respect for that on one and only soul partners, and yes, we should learn from them. Despite being abused physically, she is solely made for him, and that is not about fate. It's all about confidence, love, and humanity. Let's support, save, and strengthen humanity rather than trading humans. People need people, and we have one life to live. Let's be together with our loved ones, and let's stay together happy. A peace, beautiful picture shot in Uzbekistan, which is indeed a beautiful, wonderful place, prompts to be appreciated for the cinematography, delineates and magnificence. Title Khuda Hafiz, which means goodbye. A notable performance by Faiz Abu Malik featuring Shiv Pandit and Arab security agent officer deserves credit, plus his appearance in his film benefits a stunning commando for his thrilling action as an antagonist. A stunning performance by protagonists, although I will have to say super performance by all characters. And this film has strongly focused on human integrity and suppressing corruption with its own boundary. I appreciate such encouraging production. Another reviewer, Shorab Chaudhary. First, thanks to Farooq Kabir for his wonderful direction. Finally, Sameer gets Nargis after long hurdle, and it is shining example of authentic love. After long time watched fresh content, most of the time I used to watch Vidyut Chamal action-packed movie, but this time I saw emotional romantic thriller, which is a perfect combination of versatility. Twist is there as well, suspense, location, storyline, concept, background music was good. Sameer and Nargis had bitter and painful journey from Lucknow to Noman as Nargis got trapped by woman trafficking. This movie beautifully illustrated how women fall in trap of trafficking. Vidyut Chamal as Sameer Chaudhary, Nargis' husband, was outstanding right from the beginning of the movie. He did not run off the way to search Nargis, as it was lethal. Shivalekha Oberoi as Nargis Chaudhary, Sameer's wife, was good. Anu Kapoor as Usman Hamid Ali Murad, taxi driver in Noman, who gives a constant support to Sameer despite his life risk, other cast as well. Overall, this movie is very much watchable, and friends and family. So this was my review of the graphics, and other people says about this movie have told in the briefly, so you can watch it guys. This movie is really really good, and you can watch it on Hotstar completely. So thank you for watching guys. Khuda Hafiz is a 2020 Indian Hindi language actor thriller film written and directed by Farooq Kabir and produced by Kumar Mangat Pathak and Abhishek Pathak under Panorama Studios. It stars Vidyut Chamal and Shivalekha Oberoi with Anu Kapoor, Ahana Kumra and Shiv Pandit in supporting roles. Set during the financial crisis of 2007-2008, the film is inspired by the true events and follows Sameer Chaudhary, a young man who races against time to rescue his kidnapped wife Nargis from flash traders. The film was premiered on Disney Plus Hotstar on 14 August 2020, and it received largely positive reviews from audience. And the movie came out in the lockdown of 2020. Because of the pandemic, the movie couldn't release on the theater of India globally. Or detained by cops in a fictional Middle East country named Noman, Sameer Chaudhary, which is known as in the movie cast role, Vidyut Chamal agrees to reveal what the lad to his arrest to Mishra and Indian embassy official. In a flashback, we see that Sameer is a software engineer and businessman who falls in love with Nargis and marries her in 2007. A financial crisis in 2008 leaves them both jobless. 3 months later, they get a job in Noman with the help of Nadine, an employee at an overseas recruitment company. Nargis leaves first, and Sameer stays to wait for his documents to come. After her arrival, Nargis calls Samir in a panic, crying that someone is kidnapping her. Samir travels to Noman, where he meets Usman Hamid Ali Murad, a taxi driver. He asks Usman to take him to the addresses given by Nadeem, but learns there is no such address. Usman takes Samir to the police station, where he learns that Nadeem has gone missing. With cops not helping him, he approaches the Indian embassy he possesses as an employee of a telecom company and acquires the address of the person from whose phone Nargis contacted him, a man named Shirazi. Samir and Usman learn about Shirazi's involvement in the flash trade. Samir visits brothels and with Usman in search of Nargis and finds her in one, but he is attacked by the owners and turns on violent, killing man, followed by a car chase that ends with a crash and his arrest. In the prison, as Samir has finished narrating his story, he is approached by a Nomani cop named Faiz, who decided to help him with Officer Tamina. They view the CCTV footage of the Noman airport, where they see Nargis entering a van with a man revealed to by Stack, an Algerian modeling coordinator. Stack orders the killing of Nargis. Faiz and Tamina come across a burned corpse and believe it to be Nargis. Samir see her pendant and on it and is shattered. Following her funeral, he is given compensation tickets to India. Tamina learns Nargis is alive and the corpse they found was of different woman. She and Faiz try to find Samir before learning he never boarded the flight. Now wanting revenge, Samir disguises himself and arrives at Stack house. The two violently fight before Stack reveals Nargis is alive. Faiz and Tamina arrives and Faiz is revealed to be Stackly alive. Tamina subdues Faiz long enough to allow Samir to escape. Faiz kills Tamina and frames Samir. An ensuing chase leaves Stack dead. Faiz meets his crime partner, the boss of Stack, which is photographed by an undercover cop. Samir is captured by Faiz before his betrayal is revealed by the commissioner. Samir and Faiz engage in first fight, where Samir beats Faiz. Nargis and the other women are freed and Tamina is given a state funeral. Faiz wakes up found in the middle of a desert in front of a firing squad for his crime. They shot him to death. Samir and Nargis prepare to depart the plane of India while making the last meeting with Usman. Samir invites Usman to come to India and meet with their family. Before leaving, they call him Khuda Hafiz. This movie is following official announcement in April 2019. Shooting commenced at Uzbekistan on 14 November 2019 before the pandemic, the halting COVID started. And this movie is officially conducted at virtual press conference where Disney Plus Hotstar hosted played the movie India. A sequel titled Khuda Hafiz Chapter 2 was announced in September 22 with Kumar Mangat and Abhishek Pathak as a producer and Farooq Kabir as the director. Vidhu Chawal and Shivalekha Oberoi will reprise their roles and the sequels will go on close in March 21 before releasing in October 2019 in cinema. what other people says about this movie. Khuda Hafiz. Sujit Kumar Menon wrote, back to my favorite movie writing. This time it will be a memorable one, as the movie I had seen over an OTT platform. Till now, experience of movie was in a multiplex screen, relaxing on a couch over the top row and enjoying the show with a big box of popcorn. Thanks to COVID, which was gave me a different view of experiencing the movie. He wrote, Khuda Hafiz, a perfect weekend watch movie to Jamal, who had been seen a full of an action hero in Commando series performing breathtaking stunts, where he had shown that this caliber is not only restricted to only action generation movies. A day back of release, director Farooq Kabir had said that he had confidence on taking out Vidyut into his role, and today I applaud his forecast. Yes, Vidyut had done a marvelous act. The story revolves around the 2008 depression, where today at this COVID situation, the people who are affected the most is the middle class and the lower middle class. Here Samir lies with Jyot and his wife Nargis lies Shiva Lekha Oberoi, facing financial crisis due to 2008 crisis and throw a job opportunity in Norman. Nargis files so that a ray of sunshine enters into their life, but ill fate makes Nargis fall into the trap and become a victim of the anti-social group. And now, how Samir, who lands in Norman, rescues her forms the rest of the story. The story will very well show the difficulty of the common man whose only aim is to be their family happy and safe. We hear a lot of where women work in abroad as nurses, clerks, etc. Why? Just to show that they are working abroad in vacation, they will bring costly products and impress the society. No. In most cases, they just toiled day, night, and to spend a good amount back to their family at hometown so as to meet their daily and win. When this kind of situation happens, it's nothing but ill fate. When it comes to performance, I mentioned Vidyut had shown a different style. The pain, the worry of husband who just wants to get his wife back at any situation is very well enacted. Bollywood will definitely make Vidyut a superstar soon. Shiva Lekha Oberoi had done her part very well. Anu Kapoor, man who shown a remarkable performance in Jolly LLB 2, here was not left any chance of complaint. Kudos for them. Director Farooq Kabir had well researched on this as the true event, very well executed. As the viewers, filmmakers like should bring such fantabulous scripts which will make us the viewers watch with great level of interest. Yes, one thing the movie reaches is we believe in God, then there is no obstacle which will make us fail. Khuda Hafiz, who gave this movie 5 out of 5. And here is one of the reviewer, name is Navaparna Gautam. She wrote, amazing movie based on some of the true and pleasant happenings going on around the world, around very every corner of the cities. Besides that, it shows that true love of respect for that on one and only soul partners. And yes, we should learn from them. Despite being abused physically, she is solely made for him, and that is not about fate. It's all about confidence, love, and humanity. Let's support, save, and strengthen humanity rather than trading humans. People need people, and we have one life to live. Let's be together with our loved ones, and let's stay together happy. A peace, beautiful picture shot in Uzbekistan, which is indeed a beautiful, wonderful place, prompts to be appreciated for the cinematography, delineates and magnificent title Khuda Hafiz, which means goodbye. A notable performance by Faiz Abu Malik featuring Shiv Pandit and Arab security agent officer deserves credit, plus his appearance in his movie film benefits a stunning commando for his thrilling action as an antagonist. A stunning performance by protagonists, although I will have to say super performance by all characters. And this film has strongly focused on human integrity and suppressing corruption with its own boundary. I appreciate such encouraging production. Another reviewer, Shorab Chaudhary. First, thanks to Farooq Kabir for his wonderful direction. Finally, Sameer gets Nargis after long hurdle, and it is shining example of authentic love. After long time, watched fresh content. Most of the time, I used to watch Vidhu Chamal action-packed movie, but this time I saw emotional romantic thriller, which is a perfect combination of versatility. Twist is there as well. Suspense, location, storyline, concept, background music was good. Sameer and Nargis had bitter and painful journey from Lucknow to Noman as Nargis got trapped by woman trafficking. This movie beautifully illustrated how women fall in trap of trafficking. Vidhu Jamwal as Sameer Chaudhary, Nargis' husband, was outstanding right from the beginning of the movie. He did not run off the way to search Nargis, as it was little Shivalekha Oberoi as Nargis Chaudhary. Sameer's wife was good. Anu Kapoor as Usman Hamid Ali Murad, taxi driver in Noman, who gives a constant support to Sameer despite his life risk. Other cast as well. Overall, this movie is very much watchable, and friends and family. So this was my review of the Khudafiz, and other people says about this movie have told in the briefly, so you can watch it, guys. This movie is really really good, and you can watch it on Hotstar completely. So thank you for watching, guys. Khuda Hafiz is a 2020 Indian Hindi language actor thriller film written and directed by Farooq Kabir and produced by Kumar Mangat Pathak and Abhishek Pathak under Panorama Studios. It stars Vidhu Jamwal and Shivalekha Oberoi with Anu Kapoor, Ahana Kumara and Sivi Pandit in supporting roles. Set during the financial crisis of 2007-2008, the film is inspired by the true events and follows Sameer Chaudhary, a young man who races against time to rescue his kidnapped wife Nargis from flash traders. The film was premiered on Disney Plus Hotstar on 14 August 2020 and it received largely positive reviews from audience. And the movie came out in the lockdown of 2020. Because of the pandemic, the movie couldn't release on that theater of India globally. Or detained by cops in a fictional Middle East country named Noman, Sameer Chaudhary, which is known as in the movie cast role Vidhu Jamwal, agrees to reveal what the led to his arrest to Mishra and Indian embassy official. In a flashback, we see that Sameer is a software engineer and businessman who falls in love with Nargis and marries her in 2007. A financial crisis in 2008 leaves them both jobless. 3 months later, they get a job in Noman with the help of Nadine, an employee at an overseas recruitment company. Nargis leaves first and Sameer stays to wait for his documents to come. After her arrival, Nargis calls Sameer in a panic, crying that someone is kidnapping her. Sameer travels to Noman, where he meets Usman Hamid Ali Murad, a taxi driver. He asks Usman to take him to the addresses given by Nadine, but learns there is no such address. Usman takes Sameer to the police station, where he learns that Nadine has gone missing. With cops not helping him, he approaches the Indian embassy he possesses as an employee of a telecom company and acquires the address of the person from whose phone Nargis contacted him, a man named Shirazi. Sameer and Usman learn about Shirazi's involvement in the flash trade. Sameer visits brothels and with Usman in search of Nargis and finds her in one, but he is attacked by the owners and turns on violent, killing man, followed by a car chase that ends with a crash and his arrest. In the prison, as Sameer has finished narrating his story, he is approached by a Romani cop named Fez, who decided to help him with Officer Tamina. They view the CCTV footage of the Noman airport, where they see Nargis entering a van with a man revealed to by Stack, an Algerian modeling coordinator. Stack orders the killing of Nargis. Fez and Tamina come across a burned corpse and believe it to be Nargis. Samir sees her pendant and on it and is shattered. Following her funeral, he is given compensation tickets to India. Tamina learns Nargis is alive and the corpse they found was of different woman. She and Fez try to find Samir before learning he never boarded the flight. Now wanting revenge, Samir disguises himself and arrives at Stack house. The two violently fight before Stack reveals Nargis is alive. Fez and Tamina arrive and Fez is revealed to be Stackly alive. Tamina subdues Fez long enough to allow Samir to escape. Fez kills Tamina and frames Samir. An ensuing chase leaves Stack dead. Fez meets his crime partner, the boss of Stack, which is photographed by an undercover cop. Samir is captured by Fez before his betrayal is revealed by the commissioner. Samir and Fez engage in first fight where Samir beats Fez. Nargis and the other woman are freed and Tamina is given a state funeral. Fez wakes up found in the middle of a desert in front of a firing squad for his crime. They shot him to death. Samir and Nargis prepare to depart the plane of India while making the last meeting with Usma. Samir invites Usma to come India and meet with their family. Before leaving, they call him Khuda Hafiz. This movie is following official announcement in April 2019. Shooting commenced at Uzbekistan on 14 November 2019 before the pandemic, the whole thing COVID started. And this movie is officially conducted at a virtual press conference where Disney Plus Hotstar hosted played the movie India. A sequel titled Khuda Hafiz Chapter 2 was announced in September 22 with Kumar Mangat and Abhishek Pathak as a producer and Farooq Kabir as the director. Vidhu Chawal and Shivalekha Oberoi will reprise their roles and the sequels will go on close in March 21 before releasing in October 2019 in cinema. What other people says about this movie, Khuda Hafiz. Sujit Kumar Menon wrote, "Back to my favorite review writing. This time it will be a memorable one as the movie I had seen over an OTT platform. Till now experience of movie was in a multiplex screen, relaxing on a couch over the top row and enjoying the show with a big box of popcorn. Thanks to COVID, which was gave me a different view of experiencing the movie." He wrote, Khuda Hafiz, a perfect weekend watch movie. Vidhu Chawal, who had been seen a full of an action hero in Commando series, performing breathtaking stunts, where he had shown that this caliber is not only restricted to only action generation movies. A day back of release, director Farooq Kabir had said that he had confidence on taking out Vidyut into his role, and today I applaud his forecast. Yes, Vidyut had done a marvelous act. The story revolves around the 2008 depression, where today at this COVID situation, the people who are affected the most is the middle class and the lower middle class. Here Sameer lies Vidyut and his wife Nargis lies Shivalekha Oberoi, facing financial crisis due to 2008 crisis and throw a job opportunity in Norman. Nargis fires so that a ray of sunshine enters into their life, but ill fate makes Nargis fall into the trap and become a victim of the anti-social group. And now how Sameer, who lands in Norman, rescue her forms the rest of the story. The story will very well show the difficulty of the common man whose only aim is to be their family happy and safe. We hear a lot of where women work in abroad as nurses, clerks, etc. Why? Just to show that they are working abroad. In vacation, they will bring costly products and impress the society. No. In most cases, they just toiled day, night, and to spend a good amount back to their family at hometown so as to meet their daily and win. When this kind of situation happens, it's nothing but ill fit. When it comes to performance, I mentioned Vidyut had shown a different style. The pain, the worry of a husband who just wants to get his wife back at any situation is very well enacted. Bollywood will definitely make Vidyut a superstar soon. Shivalekha Oberoi had done her part very well. Anu Kapoor, man who shone a remarkable performance in Jolly LLB 2, here was not left any chance of complaint. Kudos for them. Director Farooq Kabir had well researched on this as the true event, very well executed. As the viewers, filmmakers like should bring such fantabulous scripts which will make us the viewers watch with great level of interest. Yes, one thing the movie reaches is we believe in God, then there is no obstacle which will make us fail. Khuda Hafiz, who gave this movie 5 out of 5. And here is one of the reviewer, name is Navaparna Gautam. She wrote, amazing movie based on some of the true and pleasant happenings going on around the world, around very every corner of the cities. Besides that, it shows that true love of respect for that on one and only soul partners. And yes, we should learn from them. Despite being abused physically, she is solely made for him, and that is not about fate. It's all about confidence, love, and humanity. Let's support, save, and strengthen humanity rather than trading humans. People need people, and we have one life to live. Let's be together with our loved ones, and let's stay together happy. A piece, beautiful picture shot in Uzbekistan, which is indeed a beautiful, wonderful place, comes to be appreciated for the cinematography, delineates and magnificence. Title Khuda Hafiz, which means goodbye. A notable performance by Faiz Abu Malik featuring Shiv Pandit and Arab security agent officer deserves credit, plus his appearance in his film benefits a stunning commando for his thrilling action as an antagonist. A stunning performance by protagonists, although I will have to say superb performance by all characters. And this film has strongly focused on human integrity and suppressing corruption with its own boundary. I appreciate such encouraging production. Another reviewer, Shorab Chaudhary. First, thanks to Farooq Kabir for his wonderful direction. Finally, Sameer gets Nargis after long hurdle, and it is shining example of authentic love. After long time watched fresh content, most of the time I used to watch Vidyut Chamal action-packed movie, but this time I saw emotional romantic thriller, which is a perfect combination of versatility, twist is there as well, suspense, location, storyline, concept, background, music was good. Sameer and Nargis had bitter and painful journey from Lucknow to Noman as Nargis got trapped by woman trafficking. This movie beautifully illustrated how women fall in trap of trafficking. Vidhu Jamwal as Sameer Chaudhary, Nargis' husband, was outstanding right from the beginning of the movie. He did not run off the way to search Nargis as it was lethal. Shiva Lekha Oberoi as Nargis Chaudhary, Sameer's wife, was good. Anu Kapoor as Usman Hamid Ali Murad, taxi driver in Noman who gives a constant support to Sameer despite his life risk, other cast as well. Overall, this movie is very much watchable and friends and family. So this was my review of the Khudafiz, and other people says about this movie have told in the briefly, so you can watch it guys. This movie is really really good and you can watch it on Hotstar completely. So thank you for watching guys. Khuda Hafiz is a 2020 Indian Hindi language actor thriller film written and directed by Farooq Kabir and produced by Kumar Mangat Pathak and Abhishek Pathak under Panorama Studios. It stars Vidhu Jamwal and Shiva Lekha Oberoi with Anu Kapoor, Ahana Kumra and Siv Pandit in supporting roles. Set during the financial crisis of 2007-2008, the film is inspired by the true events and follows Sameer Chaudhary, a young man who races against time to rescue his kidnapped wife Nargis from flash traders. The film was premiered on Disney Plus Hotstar on 14 August 2020 and it received largely positive reviews from audience. And the movie came out in the lockdown of 2020. Because of the pandemic, the movie couldn't release on the theater of India globally. Or detained by cops in a fictional Middle East country named Noman, Sameer Chaudhary, which is known as in the movie cast role, Vidhu Jamwal agrees to reveal what led to his arrest to Mishra, an Indian embassy official. In a flashback, we see that Sameer is a software engineer and businessman who falls in love with Nargis and marries her in 2007. A financial crisis in 2008 leaves them both jobless. 3 months later, they get a job in Noman with the help of Nadini, an employee at an overseas recruitment company. Nargis leaves first and Sameer stays to wait for his documents to come. After her arrival, Nargis calls Sameer in a panic, crying that someone is kidnapping her. Sameer travels to Noman where he meets Usman Hamid Ali Murad, a taxi driver. He asks Usman to take him to the addresses given by Nadine, but learns there is no such address. Usman takes Sameer to the police station where he learns that Nadine has gone missing. With cops not helping him, he approaches the Indian embassy he possesses as an employee of a telecom company and acquires the address of the person from whose phone Nargis contacted him, a man named Shirazi. Sameer and Usman learn about Shirazi's involvement in the flash trade. Sameer visits brothels and with Usman in search of Nargis and finds her in one, but he is attacked by the owners and turns on violent, killing man, followed by a car chase that ends with a crash and his arrest. In the prison, as Sameer has finished narrating his story, he is approached by a Nomani cop named Faiz who decided to help him with Officer Tamina. They view the CCTV footage of the Noman airport where they see Nargis entering a van with a man revealed to by Stack, an Algerian modeling coordinator. Stack orders the killing of Nargis. Faiz and Tamina come across a burned corpse and believe it to be Nargis. Sameer sees her pendant and on it and is shattered. Following her funeral, he is given compensation tickets to India. Tamina learns Nargis is alive and the corpse they found was of different woman. She and Faiz try to find Samir before learning he never boarded the flight. Now wanting revenge, Samir disguises himself and arrives at Stack House. The two violently fight before Stack reveals Nargis is alive. Faiz and Tamina arrive and Faiz is revealed to be Stackly alive. Tamina subdues Faiz long enough to allow Samir to escape. Faiz kills Tamina and frames Samir. An ensuing chase leaves Stack dead. Faiz meets his crime partner, the boss of Stack, which is photographed by an undercover cop. Samir is captured by Faiz before his betrayal is revealed by the commissioner. Samir and Faiz engage in first fight where Samir beats Faiz. Nargis and the other woman are freed and Tamina is given a state funeral. Faiz wakes up in a pound in the middle of a desert in front of a firing squad for his crime. They shot him to death. Samir and Nargis prepare to depart the plane of India while making the last meeting with Usma. Samir invites Usman to come to India and meet with their family. Before leaving, they call him Khuda Hafiz. This movie is following official announcement in April 2019. Shooting commenced at Uzbekistan on 14 November 2019 before the pandemic, the whole thing COVID started. And this movie is officially conducted at a virtual press conference where Disney Plus Hotstar hosted played the movie India. A sequel titled Khuda Hafiz Chapter 2 was announced in September 2022 with Kumar Mangat and Abhishek Pathak as a producer and Farooq Kabir as the director. Vidhu Chawal and Shivalekha Oberoi will reprise their roles and the sequels will go on close in March 21 before releasing in October 2019 in cinema. What other people says about this movie, Khuda Hafiz? Sujit Kumar Menon wrote, "Back to my favorite movie writing. This time it will be a memorable one as the movie I had seen over an OTT platform. Till now experience of movie was in a multiplex screen, relaxing on a couch over the top row and enjoying the show with a big box of popcorn. Thanks to COVID, which was gave me a different view of experiencing the movie." Khuda Hafiz is a perfect weekend watch movie. Vidhu Chawal, who had been seen a full of an action hero in Commando series, performing breathtaking stunts where he had shown that this caliber is not only restricted to only action generation movies. A day back of release, director Farooq Kabir had said that he had confidence on taking out Vidhu into his role, and today I applaud his forecast. Yes, Vidhu had done a marvelous act. The story revolves around the 2008 depression, where today at this COVID situation, the people who are affected the most is the middle class and the lower middle class. Here Samir lies with Vidhu and his wife Nargis lies Shivalekha Oberoi facing financial crisis due to 2008 crisis and throw a job opportunity in Norman, Nargis fell so that a ray of sunshine enters into their life, but ill fate makes Nargis fall into the trap and become a victim of the antisocial group. And now, how Samir, who lands in Norman, rescue her forms the rest of the story. The story will very well show the difficulty of the common man whose only aim is to be their family happy and safe. We hear a lot of where women work in abroad as nurses, clerks, etc. Why? Just to show that they are working abroad. In vacation, they will bring costly products and impress the society. No. In most cases, they just toiled day, night, and to spend a good amount back to their family at hometown so as to meet their daily and win. When this kind of situation happens, it's nothing but ill fate. When it comes to performance, I mentioned Vidhut had shown a different style. The pain, the worry of husband who just wants to get his wife back at any situation is very well enacted. Bollywood will definitely make Vidhut a superstar soon. Shiva Lekha Oberoi had done her part very well. Anu Kapoor, man who shown a remarkable performance in Jolly LLB 2, here was not left any chance of complaint. Kudos for them. Director Farooq Kabir had well researched on this as the true event, very well executed. As the viewers, filmmakers like should bring such fantabulous scripts which will make us the viewers watch with great level of interest. Yes, one thing the movie reaches is we believe in God, then there is no obstacle which will make us fail. Khuda Hafiz, who gave this movie 5 out of 5. And here is one of the reviewer, name is Navaparna Gautam. She wrote, amazing movie based on some of the true unpleasant happenings going on around the world, around very every corner of the cities. Besides that, it shows that true love of respect for that on one and only soul partners. And yes, we should learn from them. Despite being abused physically, she is solely made for him, and that is not about fate. It's all about confidence, love, and humanity. Let's support, share, and strengthen humanity rather than trading humans. People need people, and we have one life to live. Let's be together with our loved ones, and let's stay together happy. A piece, beautiful picture shot in Uzbekistan, which is indeed a beautiful, wonderful place, prompts to be appreciated for the cinematography, delineates and magnificence. Title Khuda Hafiz, which means goodbye, a notable performance by Faiz Abu Malik featuring Shiv Pandit and Arab security agent officer deserves credit, plus his appearance in his movie film benefits a stunning commando for his thrilling action as an antagonist. Stunning performance by protagonists, although I'll have to say superb performance by all characters. And this film has strongly focused on human integrity and suppressing corruption with its own boundary. I appreciate such encouraging production. Another reviewer, Shorab Chaudhary. First, thank to Farooq Kabir for his wonderful direction. Finally, Samir gets Nargis after long hurdle, and it is shining example of authentic love. After long time watched fresh content, most of the time I used to watch Vidhut Chamal action-packed movie, but this time I saw emotional romantic thriller, which is a perfect combination of versatility. Twist is there as well, suspense, location, storyline, concept, background music was good. Samir and Nargis had bitter and painful journey from Lucknow to Norman as Nargis got trapped by woman trafficking. This movie beautifully illustrated how women fall in trap of trafficking. Vidhut Chamal as Samir Chaudhary, Nargis' husband, was outstanding right from the beginning of the movie. He did not run off the way to search Nargis, as it was little. Shiva Lekha Oberoi as Nargis Chaudhary, Samir's wife, was good. Anu Kapoor as Usman Hamid Ali Murad, taxi driver in Norman who gives a constant support to Samir despite his life risk, other cast as well. Overall, this movie is very much watchable and friends and family. So this was my review of the Khudafiz and other people says about this movie. I have told in the briefly, so you can watch it, guys. This movie is really, really good, and you can watch it on Hotstar completely. So thank you for watching, guys. Khuda Hafiz is a 2020 Indian Hindi language action thriller film written and directed by Farooq Kabir and produced by Kumar Mangat Pathak and Abhishek Pathak under Panorama Studios. It stars with Jamwal and Shiva Lekha Oberoi with Anu Kapoor, Ahana Kumra and Shiv Pandit in supporting roles. Set during the financial crisis of 2007-2008, the film is inspired by the true events and follows Samir Chaudhary, a young man who races against time to rescue his kidnapped wife Nargis from flash traders. The film was premiered on Disney Plus Hotstar on 14 August 2020 and it received largely positive reviews from audience. And the movie came out in the lockdown of 2020. Because of the pandemic, the movie couldn't release on the theater of India globally. Or detained by cops in a fictional Middle East country named Noman Samir Chaudhary, which is known as in the movie Castrol, Vidya Chamwal agrees to reveal what led to his arrest to Mishra, an Indian embassy official. In a flashback, we see that Samir is a software engineer and businessman who falls in love with Nargis and marries her in 2007. A financial crisis in 2008 leaves them both jobless. 3 months later, they get a job in Noman with the help of Nadeem, an employee at an overseas recruitment company. Nargis leaves first and Samir stays to wait for his documents to come. After her arrival, Nargis calls Samir in a panic, crying that someone is kidnapping her. Samir travels to Noman, where he meets Usman Hamid Ali Murad, a taxi driver. He asks Usman to take him to the addresses given by Nadeem, but learns there is no such address. Usman takes Samir to the police station, where he learns that Nadeem has gone missing. With cops not helping him, he approaches the Indian embassy he possesses as an employee of a telecom company and acquires the address of the person from whose phone Nargis contacted him, a man named Shirazi. Samir and Usman learn about Shirazi's involvement in the flash trade. Samir visits brothers and with Usman in search of Nargis and finds her in one, but he is attacked by the owners and turns on violent, killing man, followed by a car chase that ends with a crash and his arrest. In the prison, as Samir has finished narrating his story, he is approached by a Omani cop named Faiz who decided to help him with Officer Tamina. They view the CCTV footage of the Noman airport, where they see Nargis entering a van with a man revealed to by Stack, an Algerian modeling coordinator. Stack orders the killing of Nargis. Faiz and Tamina come across a burned corpse and believe it to be Nargis. Samir sees her pendant and on it and is shattered. Following her funeral, he is given compensation tickets to India. Tamina learns Nargis is alive and the corpse they found was of different woman. She and Faiz try to find Samir before learning he never boarded the flight. Now wanting revenge, Samir disguises himself and arrives at Stack house. The two violently fight before Stack reveals Nargis is alive. Faiz and Tamina arrives and Faiz is revealed to be Stackly alive. Tamina subdues Faiz long enough to allow Samir to escape. Faiz kills Tamina and frames Samir. an unassuming Chase Lee Stack that first meets his crime partner, the boss of Stack, which is photographed by an undercover cop. Sameer is captured by Fess before his betrayal is revealed by the commissioner. Sameer and Fess engage in first fight where Sameer beats Fess. Nargis and the other woman are freed and Tamina is given a state funeral. Fess wakes up in found in the middle of a desert in front of a firing squad for his crime. They shot him to death. Sameer and Nargis prepare to depart the plain of India while making the last meeting with Usman. Sameer invites Usman to come to India and meet with their family. Before leaving, they call him Khuda Hafiz. This movie is following official announcement in April 2019. Shooting commenced at Uzbekistan on 14 November 2019 before the pandemic, the halting COVID started. And this movie is officially conducted at a virtual press conference where Disney Plus Hotstar hosted played the movie India. A sequel titled Khuda Hafiz Chapter 2 was announced in September 2022 with Kumar Mangat and Abhishek Pathak as a producer and Farooq Kabir as the director. Vidhu Chawal and Shivalekha Oberoi will reprise their roles and the sequels will go on pause in March 21 before releasing in October 2019 in cinema. What other people says about this movie, Khuda Hafiz. Sujit Kumar Menon wrote, "Back to my favorite movie writing. This time it will be a memorable one as the movie I had seen over an OTT platform. Till now experience of movie was in a multiplex screen, relaxing on a couch over the top row and enjoying the show with a big box of popcorn. Thanks to COVID, which was gave me a different view of experiencing the movie." He wrote, Khuda Hafiz, a perfect weekend watch movie with Jamal, who had been seen a full of an action hero in Commando series, performing breathtaking stunts, where he had shown that this caliber is not only restricted to only action generation movies. A day back of release, director Farooq Kabir had said that he had confidence on taking out Vidyut into his role, and today I applaud his forecast. Yes, Vidyut had done a marvelous act. The story revolves around the 2008 depression, where today at this COVID situation, the people who are affected the most is the middle class and the lower middle class. Here, Sameer lies with Vidyut and his wife Nargis lies Shivalekha Oberoi, facing financial crisis due to 2008 crisis and throw a job opportunity in Oman. Nargis fires so that a ray of sunshine enters into their life, but ill fate makes Nargis fall into the trap and become a victim of the antisocial group. And now, how Sameer, who lands in Oman, rescue her forms the rest of the story. The story will very well show the difficulty of the common man whose only aim is to be their family happy and safe. We hear a lot of where women work in abroad as nurses, clerks, etc. Why just to show that they are working abroad in vacation, they will bring costly products and impress the society? No. In most cases, they just toiled day, night, and to spend a good amount back to their family at hometown so as to meet their daily and win. When this kind of situation happens, it's nothing but ill fit. When it's come to performance, I mentioned Vidyut had shown a different style. The pain, the worry of a husband who just wants to get his wife back at any situation is very well enacted. Bollywood will definitely make Vidyut a superstar soon. Shiva Lekha Oberoi had done her part very well. Anu Kapoor, man who shown a remarkable performance in Jolly LLB 2, here was not left any chance of complaint. Kudos for them. Director Farooq Kabir had well researched on this as the true event, very well executed. As the viewers, filmmakers like should bring such fantabulous scripts which will make us the viewers watch with great level of interest. Yet one thing the movie reaches is we believe in God, then there is no obstacle which will make us fail. Khuda Hafiz. Who gave this movie 5 out of 5? And here's one of the reviewer name is Navaparna Gautam. She wrote, amazing movie based on some of the true unpleasant happenings going on around the world, around very every corner of the cities. Besides that, it shows that true love of respect for that on one and only soul partners. And yes, we should learn from them. Despite being abused physically, she is solely made for him, and that is not about fate. It's all about confidence, love and humanity. Let's support, save and strengthen humanity rather than trading humans. Pupils need pupils, and we have one life to live. Let's be together with our loved ones, and let's stay together happy. A peace, beautiful picture shot in Uzbekistan, which is indeed a beautiful, wonderful place, prompts to be appreciated for the cinematography, delineates and magnificence. Title Khuda Hafiz, which means goodbye. A notable performance by Faiz Abu Malik featuring Shiv Pandit and Arab security agent officer deserves credit, plus his appearance in his film benefits a stunning commando for his thrilling action as an antagonist. A stunning performance by protagonists, although I will have to say superb performance by all characters. And this film has strongly focused on human integrity and suppressing corruption with its own boundary. I appreciate such encouraging production. Another reviewer, Shorab Chaudhary. First, thank to Farooq Kabir for his wonderful direction. Finally, Sameer gets Nargis after long hurdle, and it is shining example of authentic love. After long time watched fresh content, most of the time I used to watch Vidyut Jamal action-packed movie, but this time I saw emotional romantic thriller, which is a perfect combination of versatility. Twist is there as well, suspense, location, storyline, concept, background music was good. Sameer and Nargis had bitter and painful journey from Lucknow to Noman, as Nargis got trapped by woman trafficking. This movie beautifully illustrated how women fall in trap of trafficking. Vidyut Jamwal as Sameer Chaudhary, Nargis' husband, was outstanding right from the beginning of the movie. He did not run off the way to search Nargis, as it was lethal. Shiva Lekha Oberoi as Nargis Chaudhary, Sameer's wife, was good. Anu Kapoor as Usman Hamid Ali Murad, taxi driver in Noman, who gives a constant support to Sameer despite his life risk, other cast as well. Overall, this movie is very much watchable, and friends and family. So this was my review of the Khuda Hafiz, and other people says about this movie have told in the briefly, so you can watch it guys. This movie is really really good, and you can watch it on Hotstar completely. So thank you for watching guys. Khuda Hafiz is a 2020 Indian Hindi language actor thriller film written and directed by Farooq Kabir and produced by Kumar Mangat Pathak and Abhishek Pathak under Panorama Studios. It stars Vidyut Jamwal and Shiva Lekha Oberoi with Anu Kapoor, Ahana Kumara and Sivi Pandit in supporting roles said during the financial crisis of 2007-2008, the film is inspired by the true events and follows Samir Chaudhary, a young man who races against time to rescue his kidnapped wife Nargis from flash traders. The film was premiered on Disney Plus Hotstar on 14 August 2020 and it received largely positive reviews from audience. And the movie came out in the lockdown of 2020 because of the pandemic. The movie couldn't release on the theater of India globally. Or detained by cops in a fictional Middle East country named Noman Samir Chaudhary, which is known as in the movie Castrol, Vidyut Chamwal agrees to reveal what led to his arrest to Mishra, an Indian embassy official. In a flashback, we see that Samir is a software engineer and businessman who falls in love with Nargis and marries her in 2007. A financial crisis in 2008 leaves them both jobless. 3 months later, they get a job in Noman with the help of Nadini, an employee at an overseas recruitment company. Nargis leaves first and Samir stays to wait for his documents to come. After her arrival, Nargis calls Samir in a panic, crying that someone is kidnapping her. Samir travels to Noman where he meets Usman Hamid Ali Murad, a taxi driver. He asks Usman to take him to the addresses given by Nadim, but learns there is no such address. Usman takes Samir to the police station where he learns that Nadim has gone missing. With cops not helping him, he approaches the Indian embassy he possesses as an employee of a telecom company and acquires the address of the person from whose phone Nargis contacted him, a man named Shirazi. Samir and Usman learn about Shirazi's involvement in the flash trade. Samir visits brothels and with Usman in search of Nargis and finds her in one, but he is attacked by the owners and turns out violent, killing man, followed by a car chase that ends with a crash and his arrest. In the prison, as Samir has finished narrating his story, he is approached by a Nomani cop named Faiz who decided to help him with Officer Tamina. They view the CCTV footage of the Noman airport where they see Nargis entering a van with a man revealed to by Stack, an Algerian modeling coordinator. Stack orders the killing of Nargis. Faiz and Tamina come across a burned corpse and believe it to be Nargis. Samir see her pendant and on it and is shattered. Following her funeral, he is given compensation tickets to India. Tamina learns Nargis is alive and the corpse they found was of different woman. She and Faiz try to find Samir before learning he never boarded the flight. Now wanting revenge, Samir disguises himself and arrives at Stack house. The two violently fight before Stack reveals Nargis is alive. Faiz and Tamina arrive and Faiz is revealed to be Stackly alive. Tamina subdues Faiz long enough to allow Samir to escape. Faiz kills Tamina and frames Samir. An ensuing chase leave Stack dead. Faiz meets his crime partner, the boss of Stack, which is photographed by an undercover cop. Samir is captured by Faiz before his betrayal is revealed by the commissioner. Samir and Faiz engage in first fight where Samir beats Faiz. Nargis and the other woman are freed and Tamina is given a state funeral. Faiz wakes up found in the middle of a desert in front of a firing squad for his crime. They shot him to death. Sameer and Nargis prepare to depart the plain of India while making the last meeting with Usma. Sameer invites Usma to come to India and meet with their family. Before leaving, they call him Khuda Hafiz. This movie is following official announcement in April 2019. Shooting commenced at Uzbekistan on 14 November 2019 before the pandemic, the halting COVID started. And this movie is officially conducted at a virtual press conference where Disney Plus Hotstar hosted played the movie India. A sequel titled Khuda Hafiz Chapter 2 was announced in September 22 with Kumar Mangal and Abhishek Pathak as a producer and Farooq Kabir as the director. Vidhu Chawal and Shivalekha Oberoi will reprise their roles and the sequels will go on floors in March 21 before releasing in October 2019 in cinema. What other people say about this movie, Khuda Hafiz? Sujit Kumar Menon wrote, "Back to my favorite movie writing. This time it will be a memorable one as the movie I had seen over an OTT platform. Till now experience of movie was in a multiplex screen, relaxing on a couch over the top row and enjoying the show with a big box of popcorn. Thanks to COVID, which was gave me a different view of experiencing the movie." He wrote, "Khuda Hafiz, a perfect weekend watch movie to Jamal, who had been seen a full of an action hero in Commando series, performing breathtaking stunts, where he had shown that this caliber is not only restricted to only action generation movies. A day back of release, director Farooq Kabir had said that he had confidence on taking out Vidhut into his role. And today, I applaud his forecast. Yes, Vidhut had done a marvelous act. The story revolves around the 2008 depression, where today, at this COVID situation, the people who are affected the most is the middle class and the lower middle class. Here, Sameer lies Vidhut and his wife Nargis lies Shivalekha Oberoi, facing financial crisis due to 2008 crisis, and throw a job opportunity in Norman. Nargis fires so that a ray of sunshine enters into their life, but ill fate makes Nargis fall into the trap and become a victim of the anti-social group. And now, how Sameer, who lands in Norman, rescues her forms the rest of the story. The story will very well show the difficulty of the common man whose only aim is to be their family happy and safe. We hear a lot of where women work in abroad as nurses, clerks, etc. Why? Just to show that they are working abroad. In vacation, they will bring costly products and impress the society. No. In most cases, they just toiled day, night, and to spend a good amount back to their family at hometown so as to meet their daily and win. When this kind of situation happens, it's nothing but ill fate. When it's come to performance, I mentioned Vidhut had shown a different style. The pain, the worry of husband who just wants to get his wife back at any situation is very well enacted. Bollywood will definitely make Vidhut a superstar soon. Shivalekha Oberoi had done her part very well. Anu Kapoor, man who shown a remarkable performance in Jolly LLB 2 here was not left any chance of complaint. Kudos for them. Dr. Farooq Kabir had well researched on this as the true event, very well executed. As the viewers, filmmakers like should bring such fantabulous scripts which will make us the viewers watch with great level of interest. Yes, one thing the movie rich is we believe in God, then there is no obstacle which will make us fail. Khuda Hafiz, who gave this movie 5 out of 5. And here's one of the reviewer, name is Navaparna Gautam. She wrote, amazing movie based on some of the true unpleasant happenings going on around the world, around very every corner of the cities. Besides that, it shows that true love of respect for that on one and only soul partners. And yes, we should learn from them. Despite being abused physically, she is solely made for him, and that is not about fate. It's all about confidence, love, and humanity. Let's support, save, and strengthen humanity rather than trading humans. Pupils need pupils, and we have one life to live. Let's be together with our loved ones, and let's stay together happy. A peace, beautiful picture shot in Uzbekistan, which is indeed a beautiful, wonderful place, prompts to be appreciated for the cinematography, delineates and magnificence. Title Khuda Hafiz, which means goodbye. A notable performance by Faiz Abu Malik featuring Shiv Pandit and Arab security agent officer deserves credit, plus his appearance in his movie film benefits a stunning commando for his thrilling action as an antagonist. A stunning performance by protagonist, although I will have to say super performance by all characters. And this film has strongly focused on human integrity and suppressing corruption with its own boundary. I appreciate such encouraging production. Another reviewer, Shorab Chaudhary. First, thanks to Farooq Kabir for his wonderful direction. Finally, Sameer gets Nargis after long hurdle, and it is shining example of authentic love. After long time watched fresh content, most of the time I used to watch Vidyut Chamal action-packed movie, but this time I saw emotional romantic thriller, which is a perfect combination of versatility. Twist is there as well, suspense, location, storyline, concept, background music was good. Sameer and Nargis had bitter and painful journey from Lucknow to Noman as Nargis got trapped by woman trafficking. This movie beautifully illustrated how women fall in trap of trafficking. Vidyut Chamal as Sameer Chaudhary, Nargis' husband, was outstanding right from the beginning of the movie. He did not run off the way to search Nargis, as it was lethal. Shiva Lekha Oberoi as Nargis Chaudhary, Sameer's wife, was good. Anu Kapoor as Usman Hamid Ali Murad, taxi driver in Noman, who gives a constant support to Sameer despite his life risk. Other cast as well. Overall, this movie is very much watchable, and friends and family. So this was my review of the Khuda Hafiz, and other people says about this movie have told in the briefly, so you can watch it guys. This movie is really really good, and you can watch it on Hotstar completely. So thank you for watching guys. Khuda Hafiz is a 2020 Indian Hindi language actor thriller film written and directed by Farooq Kabir and produced by Kumar Mangat Pathak and Abhishek Pathak under Panorama Studios. It stars Vidyut Chamal and Shiva Lekha Oberoi with Anu Kapoor, Ahana Kumra and Shiv Pandit in supporting roles. Set during the financial crisis of 2007-2008. The film is inspired by the true events and follows Sameer Chaudhary, a young man who races against time to rescue his kidnapped wife Nargis from flash traders. The film was premiered on Disney Plus Hotstar on 14 August 2020 and it received largely positive reviews from audience. And the movie came out in the lockdown of 2020. Because of the pandemic, the movie couldn't release on that theater of India globally or detained by cops in a fictional Middle East country named Noman Samir Chaudhary, which is known as in the movie Castrol, Vidyut Chamwal agrees to reveal what the lead to his arrest to Mishra, an Indian embassy official. In a flashback, we see that Samir is a software engineer and businessman who falls in love with Nargis and marries her in 2007. A financial crisis in 2008 leaves them both jobless. 3 months later, they get a job in Noman with the help of Nandini, an employee at an overseas recruitment company. Nargis leaves first and Samir stays to wait for his documents to come. After her arrival, Nargis calls Samir in a panic, crying that someone is kidnapping her. Samir travels to Noman, where he meets Usman Hamid Ali Murad, a taxi driver. He asks Usman to take him to the addresses given by Nadim, but learns there is no such address. Usman takes Samir to the police station, where he learns that Nadim has gone missing. With cops not helping him, he approaches the Indian embassy he possesses as an employee of a telecom company and acquires the address of the person from whose phone Nargis contacted him, a man named Shirazi. Samir and Usman learn about Shirazi's involvement in the flash trade. Samir visits brothels and with Usman in search of Nargis and finds her in one, but he is attacked by the owners and turns out violent, killing man, followed by a car chase that ends with a crash and his arrest. In the prison, as Samir has finished narrating his story, he is approached by a Omani cop named Faiz, who decided to help him with Officer Tamina. They view the CCTV footage of the Noman airport, where they see Nargis entering a van with a man revealed to by Stack, an Algerian modeling coordinator. Stack orders the killing of Nargis. Faiz and Tamina come across a burned corpse and believe it to be Nargis. Samir see her pendant and on it and is shattered. Following her funeral, he is given compensation tickets to India. Tamina learns Nargis is alive and the corpse they found was of different woman. She and Faiz try to find Samir before learning he never boarded the flight. Now wanting revenge, Samir disguises himself and arrives at Stack house. The two violently fight before Stack reveals Nargis is alive. Faiz and Tamina arrive and Faiz is revealed to be Stackly alive. Tamina subdues Faiz long enough to allow Samir to escape. Faiz kills Tamina and frames Samir. An ensuing chase leaves Stack dead. Faiz meets his crime partner, the boss of Stack, which is photographed by an undercover cop. Samir is captured by Faiz before his betrayal is revealed by the commissioner. Samir and Faiz engage in first fight, where Samir beats Faiz. Nargis and the other woman are freed and Tamina is given a state funeral. Faiz wakes up found in the middle of a desert in front of a firing squad for his crime. They shot him to death. Samir and Nargis prepare to depart the plane of India while making the last meeting with Usman. Samir invites Usman to come to India and meet with their family. Before leaving, they call him Khuda Hafiz. This movie is following official announcement in April 2019. Shooting commenced at Uzbekistan on 14 November 2019 before the pandemic, the all-time COVID started. And this movie is officially conducted at a virtual press conference where Disney Plus Hotstar hosted played the movie India. A sequel titled Khuda Hafiz Chapter 2 was announced in September 22 with कुमार मंगत एंड अभिषेक पाठक एज ए प्रोड्यूसर एंड फारूक कबीर एज अ डायरेक्टर विद्युत चावल एंड शिवालेखा उपराय विल रिप्राइज देयर रोल्स एंड द सीक्वेंस विल गो ऑन प्लस इन मार्च 21 बिफोर रिलीजिंग इन अक्टूबर 2019 इन सिनेमा। What other people says about this movie, Khudafi. Sujit Kumar Menon wrote, Back to my favorite movie writing. This time it will be a memorable one as the movie I had seen over an OTT platform. Till now experience of movie was in a multiplex screen, relaxing on a couch over the top row and enjoying the show with a big box of popcorn. Thanks to COVID, which was gave me a different view of experiencing the movie. He wrote, Khudafi is a perfect weekend watch movie. Viddu Chawal, who had been seen a full of an action hero in Commando series, performing breathtaking stunts, where he had shown that this caliber is not only restricted to only action generation movies. A day back of release, director Farooq Kabir had said that he had confidence on taking out Viddu into his role. And today, I applaud his forecast. Yes, Vidyut had done a marvelous act. The story revolves around the 2008 depression, where today, at this COVID situation, the people who are affected the most is the middle class and the lower middle class. Here, Samir lies Vidyut and his wife Nargis lies Shivalekha Oberoi facing financial crisis due to 2008 crisis and throw a job. Opportunity in Norman, Nargis files so that a ray of sunshine enters into their life, but ill fate makes Nargis fall into the trap and become a victim of the anti-social group. And now, how Samir, who lands in Norman, rescues her forms the rest of the story. The story will very well show the difficulty of the common man whose only aim is to be their family happy and safe. We hear a lot of where women work in abroad as nurses, clerks, etc. Why just to show that they are working abroad in vacation, they will bring costly products and impress the society? No. In most cases, they just toiled day, night, and to spend a good amount back to their family at hometown so as to meet their daily and win. When this kind of situation happens, it's nothing but ill fate. When it's come to performance, I mentioned Vidyut had shown a different style. The pain, the worry of husband who just wants to get his wife back at any situation is very well enacted. Bollywood will definitely make Vidyut a superstar soon. Shivalekha Oberoi had done her part very well. Anu Kapoor, man who shown a remarkable performance in Jolly LLB 2, here was not left any chance of complaint. Kudos for them. Director Farooq Kabir had well researched on this as a true event, very well executed. As the viewers, filmmakers like should bring such fantabulous scripts which will make us the viewers watch with great level of interest. Yes, one thing the movie reaches is we believe in God, then there is no obstacle which will make us fail. Khuda Hafiz. Who gave this movie 5 out of 5. And here's one of the reviewer name is Nava Parna Gautam. She wrote, amazing movie based on some of the true and pleasant happenings going on around the world, around very every corner of the cities. Besides that, it shows that true love of respect for that on one and only soul partners, and yes, we should learn from them. Despite being abused physically, she is solely made for him, and that is not about fate. It's all about confidence, love, and humanity. Let's support, save, and strengthen humanity rather than trading humans. Pupils need pupils, and we have one life to live. Let's be together with our loved ones, and let's stay together happy. A peace, beautiful picture shot in Uzbekistan, which is indeed a beautiful, wonderful place, prompts to be appreciated for the cinematography, delineates and magnificent title Khuda Hafiz, which means goodbye, a notable performance by Faiz Abu Malik featuring Shiv Pandit, an Arab security agent officer, deserves credit, plus his appearance in his film benefits a stunning commando for his thrilling action as an antagonist. A stunning performance by protagonists, although I will have to say super performance by all characters. And this film has strongly focused on human integrity and suppressing corruption with its own boundary. I appreciate such encouraging production. Another reviewer, Shorab Chaudhary. First, thank you Farooq Kabir for his wonderful direction. Finally, Sameer gets Nargis after long hurdle, and it is shining example of authentic love. After long time watched fresh content, most of the time I used to watch Vidhut Chamal action-packed movie, but this time I saw emotional romantic thriller, which is a perfect combination of versatility, twist is there as well, suspense, location, storyline, concept, background, music was good. Sameer and Nargis had bitter and painful journey from Lucknow to Noman, as Nargis got trapped by woman trafficking. This movie beautifully illustrated how women fall in trap of trafficking. Vidhut Chamal as Sameer Chaudhary, Nargis' husband, was outstanding right from the beginning of the movie. He did not run off the way to search Nargis, as it was little Shivalekha Oberoi as Nargis Chaudhary. Sameer's wife was good. Anu Kapoor as Usman Hamid Ali Murad, taxi driver in Noman, who gives a constant support to Sameer despite his life risk, other cast as well. Overall, this movie is very much watchable, and friends and family. So this was my review of the Khuda Hafiz, and other people says about this movie have told in the briefly, so you can watch it guys. This movie is really really good, and you can watch it on Hotstar completely. So thank you for watching guys. Khuda Hafiz is a 2020 Indian Hindi language actor thriller film written and directed by Farooq Kabir and produced by Kumar Mangat Pathak and Abhishek Pathak under Panorama Studios. It stars Vidhut Chamal and Shivalekha Oberoi with Anu Kapoor, Ahana Kumra and Shiv Pandit in supporting roles. Set during the financial crisis of 2007-2008. The film is inspired by the true events and follows Sameer Chaudhary, a young man who races against time to rescue his kidnapped wife Nargis from flash traders. The film was premiered on Disney Plus Hotstar on 14 August 2020, and it received largely positive reviews from audience. And the movie came out in the lockdown of 2020. Because of the pandemic, the movie couldn't release on the theater of India globally. Or detained by cops in a fictional Middle East country named Noman, Sameer Chaudhary, which is known as in the movie Castrol, Vidhut Chamal agrees to reveal what the led to his arrest to Mishra, an Indian embassy official. In a flashback, we see that Sameer is a software engineer and businessman who falls in love with Nargis and marries her in 2007. A financial crisis in 2008 leaves them both jobless. 3 months later, they get a job in Noman with the help of Nadini. an employee at an overseas recruitment company, Nargis leaves first and Samir stays to wait for his documents to come. After her arrival, Nargis calls Samir in a panic, crying that someone is kidnapping her. Samir travels to Noman, where he meets Usman Hamid Ali Murad, a taxi driver. He asks Usman to take him to the addresses given by Nadeem, but learns there is no such address. Usman takes Samir to the police station, where he learns that Nadeem has gone missing. With cops not helping him, he approaches the Indian embassy he possesses as an employee of a telecom company and acquires the address of the person from whose phone Nargis contacted him, a man named Shirazi. Samir and Usman learn about Shirazi's involvement in the flash trade. Samir visits brothels and with Usman in search of Nargis and finds her in one, but he is attacked by the owners and turns on violent, killing man, followed by a car chase that ends with a crash and his arrest. In the prison, as Samir has finished narrating his story, he is approached by a Nomani cop named Faiz, who decided to help him with Officer Tamina. They view the CCTV footage of the Noman airport, where they see Nargis entering a van with a man revealed to by Stack, an Algerian modeling coordinator. Stack orders the killing of Nargis. Faiz and Tamina come across a burned corpse and believe it to be Nargis. Samir sees her pendant and on it and is shattered. Following her funeral, he is given compensation tickets to India. Tamina learns Nargis is alive and the corpse they found was of different woman. She and Faiz try to find Samir before learning he never boarded the flight. Now wanting revenge, Samir disguises himself and arrives at Stack house. The two violently fight before Stack reveals Nargis is alive. Faiz and Tamina arrives and Faiz is revealed to be Stack Lee alive. Tamina subdues Faiz long enough to allow Samir to escape. Faiz kills Tamina and frames Samir. An ensuing chase leaves Stack dead. Faiz meets his crime partner, the boss of Stack, which is photographed by an undercover cop. Samir is captured by Faiz before his betrayal is revealed by the commissioner. Samir and Faiz engage in first fight, where Samir beats Faiz. Nargis and the other woman are freed and Tamina is given a state funeral. Faiz wakes up found in the middle of a desert in front of a firing squad for his crime. They shot him to death. Samir and Nargis prepare to depart the plane of India while making the last meeting with Usman. Samir invites Usman to come to India and meet with their family. Before leaving, they call him Khuda Hafiz. This movie is following official announcement in April 2019. Shooting commenced at Uzbekistan on 14 November 2019 before the pandemic, the whole thing COVID started. And this movie is officially conducted at a virtual press conference where Disney Star hosted played the movie India.